Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your teacher Filaris Tiri. Today we're going to look at lesson 1. From 1 lesson 14. Our topic will be on reading, and today we're going to look at our subtopic, which will be poem. And so we expect you as a learner by the end of the lesson to be able to name a poem, identify the persona in a poem. And we'll begin with the definition of a poem, which can be defined in different ways depending on the writer and even the poets. And you can say, a poem is a composition in verse, a piece of writing in which the expression of feelings and ideas is with a specific rhythm. A poem is presented in lines rather than sentences, and the lines are grouped in stanzas. The lines in a poem are grouped in stanzas. The lines are in distinct rhythmic units with the pleasing effect of a music. The last words in each line rhyme, with others forming what we call a rhyme scheme. The last words in each line rhyme, while others, with the rhyming pattern, we can have what we call a rhyme scheme. For instance, we can look at an example of a poem. The title is I Love You. We can say, I love you, and that's love, to die refusing. May still who knows be smoldering in my breast. Pray, be not be pained, believe me, of my choosing. I'd never have you troubled, nor yet distressed. I love you mutely, hopelessly and truly, with shy yet fervent tenderness aglow. Mine was a jealous passion and unruly. May heaven grant another loves you so. The poet is Alexander Pushkin. If you look at the above poem, it's a poem about love. It talks about a lover who still loves their ex-girlfriend and still wants heaven to grant him another love, that he can continue to love the ex-person. And we can see in the poem, we have our last words such as refusing and choosing. When we talk of rhyming lines, these are the words that tend to rhyme at the end of each stanza. We have another rhyming word such as truly and unruly. If we look at those two words, they can form a rhyming scheme. In a poem also, we have the experience of a poem. Just like we have said, a poem is a composition that tries to capture a moment of human experience and the feelings and thoughts associated with it. The experience is ironic. In our little poem, we encounter a deep and abiding love which is apparently not returned. And when the speaker says, finally, may heaven grant another loves you so, we are struck by irony of it. Many of us would be inclined to curse those who have rejected us. But the speaker in this poem wishes her well again, which is ironical. Again, it's a wish tinged in irony. We are meant to suspect that this person might not be anyone who loves her as the persona does. And we also have another person who is called the persona in a poem. When we talk of a persona, or when we read and study a poem, you hear a voice, the voice of a speaker. This voice should not be confused with the poet, because when we talk of a poet, it's the person who writes poem, but the persona is the voice in a poem. The I in this poem is not the poet Alexander Pushkin, but a creation of the poet, what we call the persona. The persona in this poem meditates on the experience of love that is not returned. The persona is a poetic device used to voice the message of the person. Therefore, the persona is the one who is expressing his or her feelings. Remember, a persona can be a child, a father, a mother, a relative, a neighbor, an observer, a driver, anyone can be a persona. We also have the feelings and thought. A poem combines feeling and thought, as we have called a moment of human, as we have called a moment of human experience. In Pushkin's poem, the one we've just looked at, we can see that the persona described how he loved and probably still loves the person he addresses. His feelings are therefore expressed. However, intellectually, the person also knows that he cannot impose love on her, and she has her own life to live. As we study the poem, therefore, we need to appreciate the feeling in it and the thought behind this feeling. Indeed, it is through this combination of feeling and thought that we can see the general and universal features of poetry. So when we talk of feeling and thought, this is a moment of human experience that a poet can write a poem, maybe when one is devastated, when one is in love, and when one is at broken, any moment in one's lifetime. So in our activity today, I want you to look at the following. Can you define for us what is a poem? Who is a persona? Explain the basic features of poetry. If you want to talk, to refer more, to learn more about poems, you can refer them to Excelling in English Students Book 1, third edition, which is published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can also contact us through our SMS line on, as posted, SMS line as posted, YouTube at Elimu TV, Facebook at Elimu TV, and on Twitter you can follow us at Elimu TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson.